Okay, so we're launching on three devices on the 17th of July. We've got the Samsung Galaxy S4, the Sony Xperia SP, and the Galaxy S3 LTE. What you can see here is the app that customers will use. To make it really easy for customers to get going, they download the app. Once they put in their name, email address, password, a couple of other small details, they get £5 absolutely free from us to go out and try it. When they start adding their own money, they get an additional £5 from us. So a total of £10 really to get them started in this new way to pay. Do you have any questions?
No, I think that's really straightforward.
Yeah, it is really straightforward. We spent a lot of time working on the app, making it really straightforward to use. So the first thing you see when you open the app is we have these really intuitive overlays that show the user exactly what's what on the app. Those are available on all screens. So if someone is a bit unsure about what something does, and it is very straightforward anyway, as you can see, they can tap that question mark and get the overlay. In terms of adding money, if I actually just move to my own phone, I can show you the way that a customer would load money. So I'll just quickly log in, probably filling in my PIN. There we go. But anyway, you'll see how quick it is for a customer to get into the app. The key thing here as well is you don't need to open the app to make a payment. And you don't even have to have a phone on.
Right.
So anywhere you can use a contactless card, you go to the till, the teller system will put in the amount, and you tap the terminal just like you would a contactless card.
Right.
And you can see here, so I've loaded money here, and if I just scroll over, actually you'll see how easy it is to add money. So I've got a card already associated with the account. You can load money from any credit or debit card,
right,
from any bank, and you just simply select one of the options or enter an amount that you would like to add. The important thing from a customer's perspective is getting into the app and adding money is always PIN protected. So from a security perspective, that's the minimum. Customers can also choose to have a PIN on transactions, but what we find is that although customers ask for that feature, no one really uses it. The convenience and speed in the service is about just being able to tap and pay for stuff in the shops. So that's adding card. The other thing as well is the difference between you spending money is here you can see where you spent it. So more transactions, and apologies, there's lots of test transactions here, so not necessarily exciting retailers, but yeah, you get the idea. You can go in and you can get more information on where you've spent it, when you spent it, in a way that you couldn't with getting money from a cash machine.